In some applications, you need to control a servo either with a push button or with arrival of some kind of signal or detection of voltage, temperature, pressure, any other value or parameter. As long as you can detect it and get the value, based on that value, you can send this servo to the left or right or stop it at any angle that you wish. We'll show you how you can control a servo using two buttons. One is left. This left button will move the servo to the left and until it reaches 180 degrees, and this is for the right. When you press it, it moves the servo to the right. This left, it goes to the left until it reaches 180 degrees, and you press the right, and if you hold it, it will reach to zero and stop. Here is the wiring for the servo with two push buttons. The wiring of the servo has not changed. It's the same as a single push button. On this side, we have two push buttons. The left push button, this pin have been connected to the ground, and then we used another jumper to connect the second push button here to connect it to the ground in here. And the right side of this push button have been connected to pin 2, and the right side of the last one have been connected to pin 3. The wiring for the servo is the same. For the push button, here I have used this wire connected to the ground, and then from the same ground, I have put this red wire to this point where the left pin of push button is connected. So this push button is connected to the ground via this red and black, and this is also. So both of these have been connected to the ground, and the right pin of this one is connected to pin 2. And the right wire of this push button have been connected to pin 3. Let me explain the code now. We include the servo as usual for every other servo video that I've shown you. This library must be included, otherwise it will not work. We create an instance of the class servo. And then we define servo pin at pin 9 where the servo is connected. This pin is one of the pulse width modulation pin. And the angle is the initial angle, 90 degrees. Angle step is 5 degrees, so 10 or 20, whatever you like. And we are defining left and right. These are the pin where the push button will be connected. Left pin will be connected to pin 2 and right pin will be connected to pin 3. Inside the setup, this code will run once. We initialize the serial monitor. We attach the servo pin using the servo.attach to the servo. And then for the left and right, we use input pull-up using the pin mode. This eliminates using of extra resistor, which I've explained in the previous videos. And then we set the angle. This sends the servo to the initial angle. And after that, this is just a text on the screen. Using while, we check the right. So we are running two while loop, one while loop for left in here and one while loop for the right. We check if the pin is low. When you press the button, the status of the pin will be low. So this pin will be, if it is low, then we know that the left button, the right button have been pressed. And using this method, we keep the angle between 0 to 180, and also we check if the angle is smaller than 0. We set angle to 0. This portion is if the servo angle is equal to 0, it will not do anything. Other than that, we print this. We move the servo to the angle that have been calculated in here, and after that, we print the text, we print the angle, and we print the text degrees. This portion will be executed as long as the right button is pressed. Now we wait 100 milliseconds and the loop continues. If the left button is pressed, we do exactly the same, except here you see this is bigger than 0, and also this angle sets it at 180, because when you push the button to the left, it must go up to 180. And here when you press the button continuously and it reaches to the final, it must go to the 0. In this case, we are just sending the servo to the right angle and printing this text including the angle. and the while loop continues, and then if there is no button is pushed, then the main loop will take over and the loop runs until again some push button is pushed. And here is a demonstration of controlling the servo with two push buttons with Arduino. And you will see the angle that the servo is moved will be displayed in the serial monitor. This is a left push button. When I press it, that side is my reference and it moves to the left. As you can see, the angle is displayed here until it reaches 180. 180, the last angle is here. And now if I press this, if I hold it, it goes and stop. It doesn't move. If I wanted with this every time, as you can see, it goes 5 degrees. You can change the angle from the code. But if you hold it, it just goes until it reaches 180 and stop. This goes to the left button, and that's the right, it goes to the right. So you can send signal via other means. Let's say motion sensor detects something, and when a signal goes high, you can control this to move right, and the other sensor detects something else, and you can send this to the left.